Yeah, I went over this one with the coarser one, and I'm gonna have to use that, so here we go with them. All right, let me get the camera back up around here. Well, sorry to say, but that coarse one did do a better job of doing the initial groove. Go over with the fine one and then with sandpaper. But for this in here, I'm going to have to figure out how to place myself and how I'm going to be able to get it at the right angle that it's going to be. It might be a little challenge to get it, but we will see. Let me take a short break here and get some drink down my throat, clean my nose out, because of course I forgot to put my dust mask on. Not too bright on my part, but anyway, I'll get back to you as quick as I can. All right, I tried it. I got part of it done, and I found, I guess, the best way for now to do it. It's going to be a little trickier because the way I put the lines in, I guess, wasn't quite straight. But that's just something I'll have to put up with. It's going to be real slow, so let me get my dust mask on and everything, and then I'll come back and see how it's going to go. Okay, now I have to figure out, I suppose, I don't know if turning it around is going to do any good. No, not really. So, how am I going to do you? Left-handed, but I'm not any good left-handed. Wow. Okay, I'm going to shut her off for a little bit so I can figure this one out. Well, I guess it's just about the same as I did before. Only I'm sitting at a different angle. I'm getting over here a little further. Like this, I guess it's now let me get this back around here. Let's see if this is, yeah. So we're gonna try this one out. Well, I got it done on the first one. I'm going to have to go through, get this all cleaned off. I got a big brush I can use for this. But let me get all this stuff off and get the camera back up. Right. Well, I have to say that I did get it. I got to go through it and look it over real good and make sure everything's even, flat. But I'm hoping, I'm thinking it's going to be okay. Well, like I said, there's going to be probably quite a bit of checking on this and cleaning up on the some parts that aren't deep enough. So I'll be doing that. Thank you guys for watching this so far, and I'll get back to you if I have anything really important to do or say. Okay. All right, thank you guys. Okay, I went over it, checked it, went through it again a couple times with the coarse, and I went through it with the fine diamond stone. Now it goes to the sandpaper. So I'm gonna get things ready to do some sanding, and then I'll come back and video a little bit of the sanding. It's not it's not real interesting, but we'll do some of the sanding, and then I'll just go ahead and do the rest of the sanding on my own, and hopefully we'll get to doing the grip area. I don't know if it'll be today. Might have to wait until tomorrow afternoon. But I'm going to do some sanding. I don't know if I'll even get the sanding done today. So, be back to you in a little bit. Well, right now, I am going over it with 220 grit sandpaper. And then I'll probably be going over it with 320 once I get this all done. And I'm using a brass rod. I've got brass rods that I'm going to make some things out of, and all different sizes. So I'm hoping that I can use these brass rods to get in here and do this really good, because I want this one to really end up really nice. I have got to say that this basswood stick from Treeline USA has got to be the best basswood I have ever carved on. Well, I did find this is actually a handle off of a sponge paintbrush. I kept it just to see if I might need it for something, and it does do a pretty good job of the edge. I don't want to get a big chamfer in there, but doing pretty good. Well, I'm not gonna videotape everything that I'm doing with the sanding and stuff. That would be dumb on my part. So I'm gonna go ahead and sand this out, get it all ready. I don't know if I'm gonna put anything else on this or not. I know I have to do the grip area yet. So that might be the finish of it, but I know I got to do the bottom, for the tip, and that's just a straight taper. So I'm sure I'm going to have to take it down to whatever size I need for the 1 inch. So anyway, I'm going to end this thing here, and I don't know if I'll be back to you today yet or not. I'm getting tired. It's getting late. I've been out here for a few hours, not just working on this. I've done some other things. I'm doing with the acrylic paint. I found some acrylic paint. This is gloss, and that's what I kind of wanted, was a gloss paint. And I'm trying different things to paint. Over top of polyurethane once it's been sanded and roughed up real good, or to put it on before I do polyurethane and go over it with polyurethane. I got a lot of questions and a lot of things that I experiment on, and hopefully I can get it figured out and learn more as I go, which I should. But I'm just hoping that I can do a good job for everything, show people what I do, and be able to sell these buggers. I've got a lot of money wrapped up into what I've got on hand right now, so I really need to start selling them. But anyway, that's going to be a different video. I don't know what I'm going to be able to do with that. So anyway, thank you, and get back at you as soon as we can. Bye-bye. Well, I have gone over it with 220 and 320 grit in the grooves here. They're looking pretty good, and I think I'm going to start sanding the outside. I just don't think there's anything else that I want to put on this walking stick. Scoot back here. I don't know if I put some more on, if it'd look too, I don't know, busy, as they would say. I think this is good, especially after I get this painted. It will probably be as good as it can be. So far I'm real happy with the way it's come out. I mean, it's my crosses or points are not exactly in line with each other, but I think I did a halfway decent job. 3 on one side and 4 on the other. But I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Comment. If you like it, fine. If you don't like it, tell me. Tell me why you don't like it. So, but I think I'm going to, well, I don't think I'm going to sand the shaft down. I think I'm going to do the grip area, but not today. I am tired, exhausted. It's got to be 90 outside today. Humid. Oh my word, is it humid outside. That's why I'm sitting in my shop. I would rather do the sanding and grinding and stuff outside where the fresh air is, but oh, it's just way too hot. I get a little air conditioning off of the house, because this is my shop is attached right onto the kitchen actually. So I get a little air conditioning off of that. It cools it down. Not once I'm in here for a long time with these lights going, but I have a fan going, so it it's a lot better than sitting outside, I'll tell you. But like I said, comment. Let me know what you think. We'll be talking at you later. Bye-bye. Hey everyone, new day, but I'm still working on the walking stick, the Basswood walking stick. And I started. I'm starting on the grip area, but I've already found that I'm running into problems. And I don't know what it is and what to do about it. I guess I'm going to have to talk to somebody about it. But one direction, this thing cuts like butter. The other direction, it seemed like it breaks off. It splinters. Even from the side of stick to the other side of the stick. One side cuts really nice that direction, and I get to the other side and it does the same thing, just like it's breaking off. My knives are sharp because, like I said, this thing just cuts like butter. But anyway, that's the problem I'm coming in with is it's just not, it's not cutting pretty when I go from one side to the other, and I don't know what to do about it. I guess I'll find out somehow. But anyway, I'm gonna probably go ahead and put the camera down and film a little bit of the cutting of this grip area. I'm not gonna film a lot of it because, man, it don't make no sense to film a whole lot of that. Because once you see what I'm doing, you know what I'm doing. When I get close to the end, then I'll kick the camera back on again and we'll go from there. So just wanted to let you know that I'm still having problems with my carving. So get back at you when I have a little bit more to show you. Well, that didn't make a whole lot of sense, saying that I'll show you what I'm doing for a little bit and then turn around and say I'm going to turn the camera off. So here we go. I'm just carving up. I'm trying to just lower this down. Okay, now everybody knows what I'm doing. I'm going to go ahead and turn the camera off and just concentrate on getting this down about the right size. This is a pretty good size walking stick, and it has to have that grip down further. Because it's even for me, I'm 6'2", and even for me, that grip is a little too big to be comfortable.